Our wedding day is finally here. I remember the first time I saw you walking down the stairs at your Windsor apartment and thought to myself, I need to get her number. It took a couple years, but now we are about to get married. You're my absolute best friend, rock, soulmate, and now wife. The memories we have made so far is what I cherish in my heart, from going to Italy, our first apartment, our first date, watching movies together, and playing board games at home. What I'm most excited about is the memories we will make in the future. You are the kindest, most caring, unselfish person I know. You truly make me a better person every single day. I'm the luckiest man alive to be your husband. I love you so much, Kevin.
Kevin, my love, I'd like to start this letter with a quote you know. You can't deny that you and I kind of fit like a glove. It just couldn't be truer. I feel like we complement each other in the ways that we are different and challenge each other in the ways that we are the same. You are the yin to my yang. You have filled my life with so much joy and given me a sense of peace. You are the love of my life, and I will always put you before all else. I will always show you how much I care for you. Marrying you today is honestly the easiest thing in the world to do because I love you so much. I always knew you were the one, and I want nothing but your happiness. You are genuinely one of the most thoughtful and considerate people I've ever met. Without you, I would never know where my phone is. When you tell me I'm okay, it's like you make all my worries of the world go away. You are that strength I needed. With you, I know we can do anything. I am so proud and lucky to soon call you my husband. And I am proud to become your wife. You still give me butterflies. So today, I will make the most sincere promise my heart can make. But one lifetime with you could never be enough. I love you so much. Your soon-to-be wife.
Whatever may come, your heart I will choose. Forever I'm yours, forever I do. I get to love you. I get to love you. The way you love.
They say love is a journey. Hello and welcome, loved ones. I am Pedro, Kevin and Megan's brother-in-law. Thank you all for coming today to share in this wonderful occasion. You have come from all over to support two of our favorite people on their special day and to witness and celebrate their marriage. Over the course of their relationship, Kevin and Megan have developed a strong bond based on shared values and mutual respect. With a solid foundation from which to grow, they have made the decision to take the oath of marriage and spend the rest of their lives together. As they finalize this union, they will begin a new life of partnership, one defined by shared hopes, dreams, and successes. Married life is full of surprises, adventures, and memory-making, all made possible by their love. Kevin and Megan, welcome to your day. I am so honored and thankful to be a part of your wedding. There is no place I would rather be. Please take these moments to hold hands, really look at each other, and savor today. Any good love story is not just one moment. It's the culmination of all the moments that a couple has shared and all of the moments to come. The big ones like today, and perhaps even more importantly, it's the thousands of little moments that fuse together into one beautiful life. Kevin and Megan, you are both here today not because you can't live apart, but because you have found that life is better when you are together. You two chose to stand up here today together and commit. To be successful, you will need strength, courage, patience, and a really good sense of humor. This new journey will be at times richly rewarding and extremely difficult. But most importantly, it will be a journey you take together. You are embarking on yet another chapter of your life, and we are here today to honor that. Kevin and Megan would like to invite Kevin's uncle, Dan Botsford, to come up to do a reading.
Hi, I'm Kevin's uncle and Megan's uncle, Dan, and we are blessed to be here today. A reading from the Apostle Paul. First letter of Corinthians, chapter 13, verses 4 through 7. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres.
Thank you, Dan. Kevin and Megan have written vows to each other and will now read them aloud.
Megan, over the last 6 years, you've taught me so much about love, hard work, partnership, friendship, and cleaning. With those things in mind, I vow to love you forever. Work on becoming 1% better as a partner and teammate every day. For the rest of our lives, I promise not to lose our friendship and fun we always have together. Lastly, I will try my best do the dishes correctly and not throw any of your delicate laundry in the dryer. I love you.
Why couldn't it be more true? Kevin, it's impossible for me to put into words just how much I love you. You are my person, my love, my life. You complete me in ways I didn't know possible. Thank you for accepting me for all that I am, including my anxiety. And I promise to love you for all that you are. I vow to be your best friend like you are mine. I promise to try to sit down and actually watch football on Sundays with you. I will listen to you, support you, grow with you, and put us first when our journey may become challenging. We both know how indecisive I can be, but if there's one decision I know is the right one, it's to spend the rest of my life with you. I have no doubt this is meant to be. You've shown me more love than I've ever known, and I'm so excited to share it with you.
Do you, Kevin, take Megan to be your lawfully wedded wife, to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, in sorrow and in joy, to have and to hold, from this day forward, as long as you both shall live.
I do.
Do you, Megan, take Kevin to be your lawfully wedded husband, to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, in sorrow and in joy, to have and to hold, from this day forward, as long as you shall live?
I do.
And now we'll do the exchange of the rings. A ring is an unbroken circle with ends that have been joined together, and it represents your union. It is a symbol of your infinite love. When you look at these rings on your hands, be reminded of this moment, your commitment, and the love you feel for each other. Kevin, place the ring on Megan's finger and repeat after me. Megan, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
Megan, I give you this ring as a symbol of our love.
With the pledge to love you today, tomorrow, always, and forever.
With the pledge to love you today, tomorrow, always, and forever.
And now, Megan, place the ring on Kevin's finger and repeat after me. Kevin, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
Kevin, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
With the pledge to love you today, tomorrow, always, and forever.
With the pledge to love you today, tomorrow, always, and forever.
Kevin and Megan, today you have called on friends and family to witness and celebrate this amazing day. You have exchanged vows and have represented your commitment with wedding rings. Life is truly better when you embrace the open road in front of you with gratitude, a light heart, and the one you love. By the authority granted by me from the state of New York, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Sana.
Yeah. important people. First in, please show some love for the parents of the groom, Tom and Mary Kay Santa. Coming in right behind them, we have the parents of the bride, Ivan and Estelle Van Ass. And next, we have our wedding party. They are pumped up and ready to go. So get excited for Mitch Turner and Monica Santa.
I was gonna make you mine. And there it is, their first dance. What a beautiful way to kick off our session. And so with that, friends and family, you can all go ahead and find your seats, except for Megan and Ivan, because they're going to be going right into their father-daughter dance. And here it is. This one is an absolute classic by heart now. Entitled, I Love You First.
Look at the two of you dancing madly, lost in the moment, in each other's face. So much in love, you're alone in this place. Like as nobody else in the world. I was still means the world to me, just so you know. So be careful when you hold my girl. Time changes everything that was known. I'm not gonna stand in your way. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart will always be hers.
Megan and Ivan. And with that, Kevin, it is your turn, my friend. So if you could please invite Mary Kay to the dance floor. And then we'll be dancing to Rascal Flatts' My Wish.
I'm Meg's sister, Jess. So I'm going to keep this really short and sweet because, let's be honest, we all came to party and celebrate the newlyweds, not to hear me talk. Meg, I'm so happy for you. You found someone to spend your days and nights with, someone to share life with. I was hesitant at first meeting Kevin, wondering who this guy was raiding our fridge. I love you. We soon came to find out you're a wonderful guy. We're so lucky to have you be our family's sports coordinator. Thank you. You're an amazing uncle to Lennox, and I'm sure you'll love, the next one will love you just as much. So Kevin, officially welcome to the family. Raise your glasses, my water. To the new Mr. and Mrs. Santa.
Yeah. And I'm just gonna use this.
Here, Christine. Hold
Thank
this.
You.
We do. That's all that counts.
Yes, please. Hello, everybody. Bonjour to some. My name is Christina, and I'm here today as my best friend's maid of honor. Megan and I first met in first grade and have been best friends for 25 years. We have been horribly unfocused study buddies, partners in crime, listeners, talkers, and yes, let's face it, gossipers too. Megan and I have always cherished how long we've been best friends. So, in honor of being best friends, Megan and I decided we wanted to get best friend tattoos. So how do you make that big decision of something that will be on your body forever and literally ever? Well, we just went to Google. Megan and I typed in best friend tattoos. There was just one symbol that kept coming up. I mean, 9 out of 10 times, this one symbol just continuously popped up. So naturally, that's what we chose. I mean, it's Google. They know everything, right? Megan and I, being so brave together, each had the best friend symbol tattooed on the back of our necks. Best friends forever. To this day, Megan and I still aren't sure of the symbol's true meaning. So if anyone has any knowledge of symbols in Zebu, Megan and I have a few questions. Now along comes Kevin. Kevin has always been the one for Megan. Megan couldn't stop talking about this boy named Kevin on the lacrosse team from U-Heart. Any story Megan would tell us, it would always end up in the same spot, how much she was into Kevin. So Kevin, Megan has been my responsibility for 25 years now. Today, I'm officially giving you the role of stand-in best friend. Okay, like maybe, like only a little bit. Let's not get carried away. Friends are the family you choose for yourself, and I'm so lucky to have chosen Megan. You're the Monica to my Rachel. So let's please, again, all raise our glasses. Je vous fais toast to your health, a Voltra Tante, and a long, loving marriage to the bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Santa.
all you.
Good luck.
Yep. Simple. It's not going to be short. It's not going to be sweet. Okay. It's going to be a lot of things about that.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Patrick. I'm Kevin's younger brother. It's true when they say giving a speech is nerve-wracking. Personally, I struggle ordering at restaurants, but here we go. I'd like to start off and say that both of you look amazing tonight, and I'm honored to be standing here as your best man. Many of you probably know Kevin as the life of the party, fun-loving, and a professional darty thrower, which he is. But growing up with him, I got to experience every other quality, too. Kevin can't help but coach. Whether it was teaching me how to be tough, which I still do get reminded about daily, or what to do on the lacrosse field, or just screaming at our beer pong team because we're down one cup. He's literally programmed to be an older brother, which in terms makes him the best coach I've ever had. He's actually been prepping me for the Olympics since I was 12. beer Olympics, that is. All of these groomsmen over here know because they've lost to Kevin and I so many times. But although I did have an advantage, I was sober. But that just goes to show, Kevin knows who he wants on his team. He is someone I look up to, and of course, the one I'm constantly compared to. With Kevin, there is no one else I'd rather be associated with. You're not such a bad person to be compared to, after all. But the one thing he did that I will never do, marry a Patriots fan. I was actually the first one in my family to meet Megan. Kevin and I were out of town for some lacrosse tournament. We were staying in this dodgy hotel, the sleep under the covers bad. And Kevin tells me that Megan's gonna come over and I'm gonna have to leave the room. Megan finally gets there, and Kev like hands me his laptop so I can pass the time or whatever. And we go down the lobby together. And as soon as we get down there, he pushes me into this little sitting area right out of the way, right out of sight. I don't even get to meet Megan before they run upstairs together. I'm not too upset though, you know. I get to go throw on some Netflix, just hang out. But not even halfway through my show, Kevin texts me, "Okay, you can come up now." And I'm honestly disappointed because I didn't even get to watch a whole episode. So Megan, good luck with that for the rest of your life. I'm crossing my fingers for you. But Megan, I am so excited to be welcoming you into our family. We all love you, and I'm sure you'll find us to be a warm, supportive, and overly competitive bunch. But don't worry, Meg holds her own. I mean, she is the 2020 reigning Euchre champion. Yep. And for those of you who don't know what that is, it's a big deal, really big. So please note, Kevin has never won in his 28 years of life, just zero wins. Megan, you are the fourth sister I definitely did not need, but I am over the moon to have. I cannot imagine a more perfect woman and wife for Kevin. You complement each other beautifully, and there never seems to be a dull moment when I'm around you two. So would everyone please join me in raising your glass to Megan and Kevin? I love you guys. Cheers to forever. Thank God that's over.
That was great.
I will fight. I will fight for you. I always do until my heart is black and blue. I will stay. I will stay with you. We'll make it to the other side like lovers do. I'll reach my hands out in the dark and wait for yours to interlock. I'll wait for you. I'll wait for you. Black and blue.